still moving west to northwest at about 16 miles an hour on a course with Turks and Caicos, and after that, Florida. And it's beginning to look more and more like that turn, that much-needed turn to keep it off of land, is not going to happen fast enough. So right now, still 175 mile an hour wind, and now up to 40 miles south of Grand Turk and the Turks and Caicos. So here we go. We're going through the Turks and Caicos. We are not going to go through the Bahamas. Probably the cone is going to keep it off of the mountainous areas of Cuba. The far southern part of the cone is there, and that would be great news if this thing could just hit some mountains and weaken, but it does not look like that's going to happen. It looks like perhaps it's going to be somewhere on the southern tip of Florida. All the forecast models are going in there now, and that would be perhaps as early as this right here that you see, this line. This is Saturday. This would be Sunday morning in Miami. Then we go on up the coast, and it stays over land. And that is going to be up in the northern portion, perhaps, of Florida by sometime on Monday in the afternoon, and then continuing on up into Georgia. So this is a new cone that is now shifting further west. And in my experience, when about 48 hours out, that cone starts shifting west, rarely does it start adjusting back east. This is starting to get itself finalized. So this is very bad news for Florida. It looks like it will be a direct hit. But we will keep you updated. And again, anywhere in this cone, so let's hope. Let's just hope for open water, guys.